Hi everyone, it's only me, Susie. How you doing? Yeah, I'm makeupless today. Well, I wasn't earlier. I've just taken it all off. So, yes, this is me, au naturel. I know, minging, what can I say? Any hoodles, I can only apologise for looking a bit rough. But what it was, I was listening to a radio show that we have here. It's like a kind of conversational type show. No music. And they were talking about the government thinking about implementing this new training scheme for, I don't know if it's for everybody, but for those people that possibly would need it, but sort of self-defense classes. Self-defense classes for not just for, like, you know, fun, but you know when you're traveling on transport over here, when you're out about in public, you know that it's we've had kind of a high a rise in kind of personal attacks, if you like, over here, especially on our London Underground and buses, which I thought was really interesting. And I thought also, you know, the money that it will cost to do that, there must be a real need for it, you know, if they're even suggesting it. But anyway, so what I wanted to do was to tell you about, well, firstly, I think it's a good idea, because I have actually attended classes like that when I went to work in the NHS. I know you're thinking, well, you know, violence in the NHS, but yeah, you do get that, you know. And basically they send you off this induction course, and part of that was how to diffuse, you know, arguments and sort of confrontations, you know, towards yourself or anybody else that might need a bit of psychology rolled in. Anywho, you'll find it really, really interesting, a bit disturbing, and I've never had to use it. But there was a time when about 5 years ago, when I used to travel really early on the buses. So in the winter, it's usually dark. So it can feel a little bit more menacing, even though there's like a bus full of people. Anywho, I was sitting there minding my own business, and the bus pulled up at this stop. And nobody else got on except for this guy. But he dragged behind him his bicycle, and it was evident, looking at it, that it had a puncture on its tyre. Anywho, my instinct was, poor sod, do you know what I mean? You're on your way to work, you know, cycling, trying to feel good and get a little bit fitter and whatever, and you get a puncture, what a bummer. And so he pulled the bike on, but I knew, travelling on buses all my life in London, that bicycles are not allowed on buses. So I waited, and I waited. I'm just doing a thingy, just in case you're wondering. And I thought, in a minute, the bus driver's going to say something. Now, on our buses, we don't have conductors anymore. In my day, they used to have conductors. There'd be somebody who comes around and kept the change, and keeps order, and, you know, that sort of thing. Anyway, so the bus driver's behind his little plastic screen. He's right down the other end. It's a bendy bus, so it's quite long. Anyway, and he'd pulled his bike sort of into the middle. And sure enough, the bus driver, if you can imagine, the bus driver's at the front of the bus. The guy's in the middle where the two doors are, and I'm just behind him there at the doors. They're sitting down. And there's only a couple of people like standing up, but they were further on. So it was room. Anyway, the driver opened the door and he went, sorry mate, he went, no bikes allowed, and shut the door. I thought, oh god, that was a bit rude. Oh well, hopefully he'll just get off. No chance. I thought, here we go. I'd only been at this job, by the way, just a couple of weeks, and I was on a kind of probationary sort of period, as you are with a new job. So, of course, I was eager to not be late for work. I'm never late for anything anyway. I mean, okay, I can't say never because I'm not a 100% perfect person, but I could probably say that 98% of the time, I am not late for anything. I'm In fact, I'm early, you know. So I was flapping now, starting to flap. I'm like looking at my watch and I'm thinking, oh, come on, you know, get your bike off and then we can like start rolling. Driver didn't come out of his little place, driver's seat and little box area that he has. And there's, you know, all the passengers now are all focused on this guy to get him, like hoping that he'll get off the bus. Nobody's saying anything. But he's like arguing back now. He's like, what do you mean? What do you mean? Shouting down at the driver. And the driver's ignored him now. He's not even saying anything. He's not looking at him, nothing. I can see him. If I go like that, I can see him down there. And I can see he's just got his face on the road. And he's just waiting now. He's got the doors open. Nobody's saying anything. And this guy ain't budging. Anyway, so we're sitting there. It must be like a couple of minutes, maybe less. And he's going, mate, he said, come on. He goes, I want to get to work. He said, it's only me bike. Do you know what I mean? He goes, it's got a puncture. He goes, I've got to get to work. And you can see he was really stressed out. Anyway, and I'm thinking, yeah, hurry up, mate, because I want to get to work, you know. And everyone else is like looking around and checking the time and, you know, sort of looking a little bit anxious. So anyway, I thought in a minute, he's going to get off. Or the driver's going to come round and say, look, you know, kindly sort of say, you know, I understand and all that, but, you know, maybe tie your bike up or whatever and, you know, come back, get on the bus and then come back later for it or get a cab or whatever. Anyway, no, the driver stayed there. I mean, personally, if I'd been the driver, I would have come forward. But anyway, I'm trying to speed it up. I might have to do this in two parts. Anyway, so so I'm thinking to myself, oh, mate, come on. And he's tapping his foot now and he's getting really annoyed because now he's getting embarrassed because everyone's looking at him, as you can imagine. And I'm sort of looking, trying to look, sort of not look at him. And sure enough, this guy next to me in the seat aligned with me piped up. And he went, come on. He goes, can you get your bike off the bus? He said, because we want to get to work. We've got places to go. Anyway, he wasn't polite about it. And the other guy went, why don't you shut your mouth? I thought, oh, here we go. Here we go. I only want to go to work. I don't need this, do you know what I mean? I don't need entertainment to go home, I mean to go to work. So anyway, so now there's this little sort of like row going on between the two, and the guy with the bike got really arsy because now he's embarrassed because everyone wants him to get off now. Everyone's sort of not saying anything, but that the general atmosphere, you can kind of just tell that everyone's like got this thing, they know that he's in the wrong and he needs to just get off, but he don't want it because he's going to be late. So, anyway, so this is other guy now, and he's getting ruder, and he's getting... Anyway, so there's banter going on. And the guy next to me jumped up out of his seat and walked straight up to him like that in his face. I thought, well, we don't need... Sorry, you've gone off. I thought, we don't need this. So I looked around. Nobody was doing anything. People were looking out the window now at this point. Suddenly sitting, it's not going on like it's invisible. Right, and they've all gone stone deaf. And they're looking out the windows, and I've got the newspapers up. So I jumped out of my chair, and I ran in between the two of them. And I went to the bloke, well, I stuck my hand on like their chest, both of them, and I just pushed them apart. And I went, listen, I said to the guy that got off of his seat, I went, you're not helping, all right? I said, go and sit down. I said, and let me sort it out. I said, because you're not helping. Well, believe it or not, he turned around and walked back to his seat. Anywho, so I turned around to the bloke and I went, mate, I said, look, you're not the driver ain't going to go. What's going to happen is, it's all going to kick off here with you and whoever. I said, and the driver's going to phone the police. I said, then we'll be sitting here till the old Bill come along. I said, then you'll be carted off when you should be really going to work. I said, and on top of that, I said, seriously, I said, I've just started my job. I said, if I'm late, it's for me with the job. I said, and I've been unemployed for a long time. I said, I really need this job. I went, and he went, yeah, well, he shouldn't say this, and he shouldn't say that. And he was more kind of, you know, upset with this bloke. So I went to him, look in my eyes. I went, ignore him. Don't look at nobody else. Just look at me. I said, do me, personally me, even though you don't know me, I said, do me a favour and just take your bike off. I said, get a cab, tie it up, do something. I said, but you ain't going to get to work on time. I said, that's established. I said, and that driver ain't going nowhere. I said, what's going to happen is you're going to get nicked. I said, and it really ain't worth it. I said, and all of us are going to be late. I said, and I'm going to lose my job. I said, seriously, I said, just do it for me. I said, don't look at nobody else. Don't look at no one. Just keep your head down, get your bike off. I'm telling him this right near his face. I said, just do that for me, for nobody else, just me. Do you know what he did? Got off the bus. Couldn't believe it. Anyway, I sat down, right, because he's got off, and old Murphy, here, he's going, yeah, he goes, you should have done that in the first, I went to, do you know what I mean? I went, shut up, mate. I said, I've just sorted him out. I said, don't wind him up, or I'll let him have ya, like that. Anyway, he shut up, and I went to the driver, and driver, can you shut the door? Like that, because the bloke's off the bus now. But the driver, I don't know if he's reading a newspaper or what he's doing, but he didn't even shut the door. Anyway, so I don't know what happened, but I basically took control of this situation. I don't know why, I don't know how. I've never done it before. And it was weird. But I just want to ask anybody if you've ever done anything like that yourself. Make a video of it. I'd love to hear the story. And, you know, how do you think that something like that should be resolved? Would you try that? You know, I know it's probably a bit different for men because they kind of find it more of a challenge, if you like, you know, man on man sort of thing. But, you know, get a bit heated, a bit aggressive. Maybe in a female helps. I mean, I'm only 5'4", you know, but I've got confidence, I suppose, and I'm a bit gobby. And I think I was right. So, anyway, I've got to go. But let me know. Keep it real. See ya.